Welcome back to Let's Play Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep, Terra's Route. So we're going to open this up, and I'm going to try to get through my train of thought that I started in the last game, and I'm just going to review real quick. So, if we take a look at Ventus's entire storyline, really, and it starts with him being manipulated, put in a dangerous situation, and hurt by someone that he trusted. He subsequently is severely marred. His heart is broken, basically, into literally. It could even be argued that a piece of his soul was taken from him. Okay? Okay, so a piece of his soul is taken from him. He loses his memory. He is then forced into a situation and is basically a broken person. Fine. Whatever. Next. He manages to gain back his memory. But before he can get comfortable really for too long, because they all look the exact same age as they were when Ventus came along, so it couldn't have been more than a few months. And of those months, he had some painful growth to go through of remembering, of trying to gain some form of identity for himself. And only to discover that a piece of his soul was ripped out and is now the antagonist of his entire adventure, basically. And to a certain extent, that creates a feeling of guilt, because that makes it his fault as well. So, he's reunited, but he can't inhabit his body anymore and must seek refuge in the heart of another, a small boy. Okay, fine. He is there for at least 10 years while Sora is growing up. Alright, well, maybe Sora isn't quite 4 when he comes out. I think Sora's supposed to be, what, 14? Something along that line, but it's still many years that he inhabits Sora's heart as a place of refuge, and he never really, as far as I know, he doesn't escape. Sora is eventually turned into a Heartless, and Sora's turned into a Heartless, but can we say that Roxas is true to Sora's nobody, given that it takes on the form of Ventus? Given that Ventus's heart is not inhabiting his body anymore, could it be that Sora's body became Ventus's nobody to some degree? That still doesn't make a whole lot of sense, given everything that happened in Chain of Memories, but whatever. I think it makes more sense to say that Roxas is Ventus's nobody than Sora's. I think that makes more sense. And, as we can see, everyone else's nobody, Lee, which was Axel, and basically all of Organization 13, their nobodies didn't look a whole lot different from themselves. Not really. The hair might have been a little longer, but that's about it. The hairstyles changed. That was it. But Roxas looks a whole lot different from Sora. So could it be said that Sora, or not Sora, but that Ventus is Sora's nobody? Not Sora's. Roxas is Ventus's nobody. I'm sorry. I'm getting lost in the convoluted logic of everything, pretty much. And in that case, then Roxas then has to deal with losing his memory yet again, and I apologize for the dog barking in the background. But he loses his memory again and is basically manipulated by the same person that hurt him the first time. He makes friends with, I don't even know what to call her, but it's Shion from 358 over 2 days, which, okay. And then he has to watch her go. He basically becomes bitter and angry at the world, which is understandable. And then he's captured, where he lives in this false world, which is then shattered before him, as he's forced to fight his best friend. Ventus is like the punching bag of the fucking series. And there goes the monetization for this video. I don't, you know what, I'm monetizing videos, and if the YouTube algorithm or someone detects that I'm sharing, then, you know, it is what it is. But, I mean, I just, Like, what is it with the suffering of Ventus in this game? I swear. I mean, Ventus has to go through a lot of shit. And I don't know. I feel like Ventus is unfairly treated in this series. And I apologize if you hear my sister in the background. But, I don't know what to make of that, ultimately. I just thought it was interesting, and, just a second. Not for a while, but I am back. And we're gonna finish out. Alright, once this little fucker dead. My train of thought about where I was going. I believe we were talking about how Ventus is basically the punching bag for the entire game. Oh. Ven? Hey,
Terra! Aqua!
Well, the boss fight came sooner than I was expecting. Continue, where does it put me? Oh, bullshit! It put me all the way back here? Are you fucking serious? I can't believe it put me all the way back here. Fuck these things, I'm not fighting any further. I'll fight the one group. That's at the very end here, but that's it. Oh man, don't tell me that I lost any level ups and stuff I got from. Oh my god. Well, you know what? I don't care. I don't give a fuck. I'm gonna beat this one. I'm gonna open this. Get that thing down. And then we're moving on. I'm gonna hang out right over here until all the enemies decide to just kind of disappear. And then I'm going into my command decks. And we're gonna change Blizzara to a cure. And just for the heck of it, let's go ahead and fire strike, and then we'll just throw something else in for the heck of it. There we go. And then we have Blizzara and sliding dash, and then we'll just throw in a random one. Wonderful. Now, that leaves me with an empty space here, and we're just going to do thunder. There we go. Now let's move on. Can I just skip the cutscene? There we go. And let's try this again. So I wonder if like retry would just restart the boss battle. To me, if you press like the top one, the very first option, that should just restart the boss battle. It should be like the second option. Yeah, I suck at playing Terra. That's what I'm learning from this, is that I suck at playing Terra. Come on, this thing is almost down. Now that that's all done, once this next cutscene is over, I can end the part.
Terra!
Ben, now! Come on!
Huh?
Got him.
We make a good team.
Sure do. Oh, yeah. I got you these tickets.
For what?
lifetime passes to Disney Town. He said to... He said to take two grown-ups.
You mean us? Listen to me, Ven. We need to get you home.
It's okay, Aqua. Trust me, that guy in the mask is history. We'll never badmouth Terra again.
You saw the boy in the mask?
Yes?
Vanitas. Ven, you let Aqua take you home.
No way! I want to go with you guys.
You can't. We have a dangerous task ahead of us. I don't want you to get hurt.
And what is this dangerous task, Terra? It doesn't sound like what the Master told you to do.
It might be a different route, but I'm fighting the darkness.
I'm not so sure. I've been to the same worlds as you, and I've seen what you've done. You shouldn't put yourself so close to the darkness.
Listen to yourself, Aqua. Terra would never...
You mean you've been spying on me? Is that what he said to do? The Master's orders?
He was only...
Aqua.
I get it.
Terra!
Just stay put. I'm on my own now. All right?
Terra, please, listen. The Master has no reason to distrust you, really. He was just worried.
Master Xehanort is the only one I can still count on.
You must be Terra. It's that old coot. He won't stop asking for you. I came all the way out here to get you, just so he'd clam up.
What do you mean?
Ha! Do I have to spell it out? Xehanort, whatever he's called. You know, my prisoner.
You're apparently not a very good liar. Master Xehanort would never let himself be caught by a thug like you.
As if. I got the old coot at my mercy. See for yourself. I'm holding him underneath the outer gardens. Better show up before I lose my patience. Ciao.
There's no way it's true. But no harm in looking.
All right, so we're going to end it here. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.